A long time ago, there were many, many people on the Earth. And everyone did whatever they wanted to without love for each other. They cared more about themselves than they did about other people. God was very sad because everyone had forgotten his way. Everyone, that is, except for Noah and his family. Noah and his family worked very hard, and they kept all of God's ways in their hearts.
All right, that's enough for today. You boys can finish that tomorrow.
But Father, we almost had it. Just a few more minutes.
God knows how hard you work, Japheth, my boy, and so do I. But God also wants us to keep up our strength so that we can do his work.
You're right again, Father. You must be the wisest man in the world.
Me? Oh, no. I might be the happiest man in the world, but the wisest, I think not. But enough talking. We'd better hurry. I think we're having your mother stew tonight. We wouldn't want it to get cold.
Noah and his family had a hard life, but they loved each other very much, and they always had enough to eat. Noah never forgot that it was God who made all of those things possible.
And thank you, God, for everything you've given to me and my family. Thank you for the strength to work hard, and for fields that are good for growing, and for the food on our table. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
What's this? It sounds like we have visitors. Well, you must be hungry. Dear, will you please bring me a bit of meat and a bone from the stew? I think our friends need something to eat. All of God's creatures are important. There you go. Enjoy. Nothing like a good dinner, isn't that right?
You're a good man, Noah.
More?
One night after supper, everyone kissed Noah goodnight and went to bed. But Noah didn't go to bed at his usual time. He had a strange feeling.
You look sleepy, dear. Why don't you go to bed?
Are you coming?
Soon. I don't feel tired. I think I'll go out and look at the stars for a bit.
Noah went out of his house for some fresh air. He had a feeling he couldn't explain. He didn't know that God was leading him outside.
Ooh, what is this?
Noah?
God, is that you?
Yes, Noah, it is. Please listen to the important things I have to say to you. Noah, people do not love one another as they should. So I have decided to wash the earth with a flood and start over.
This is terrible news.
Don't be afraid, Noah. I'm telling you this because you are the only man who still has me in his heart. I have chosen you and your family to help me start over. Listen carefully. I want you to build a boat, Noah, an ark.
So much to do. Oh, I've got to get my boys and have them help me. Wake up! I need you to help me with a big project.
Ooh.
Yes, I'm serious. An ark, a big, big ark. It's okay. Go ahead and laugh. You'll see. This field should be big enough.
Build it from fresh, sticky wood. Make it 450 feet long, 75 feet across, and 45 feet high. Seal the planks with tar. And inside, build an upper, middle, and lower deck.
Hi, Father!
Hi.
Make an opening all the way around the ark, just below the upper deck.
Yay!
And last, put a door in the side big enough for the largest animals of the earth to walk through. Next, bring two of every animal on the earth with you, each with a safe place on the ark. Thank you.
Noah and his family worked very hard.
Father, we're finished!
Yay!
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 We have done well, my sons.
Where is this old man who says a flood is coming? Lead me to the crazy fool.
My father is no fool.
Only a fool would build a big silly boat in the middle of his field. Now let's take a good look at it. You really are a crazy old man. Anyone who would do this.
You would be wise to listen to what I say. God has told me that a terrible flood is coming. So much to do, so little time.
Father?
It's fair to warn them, Shem.
Warn us about what? The flood that's never coming? Come on, let's get out of here. Let's leave this crazy old man alone.
There, there now. Thank you for helping us. I guess we made ourselves some friends, eh? And it looks like we have our first passengers. Now, if I can only figure out how we're going to find all the rest of the animals.
Shh, quiet now, you two. Can't you see he's trying to think?
Father, look!
It's a miracle!
And it was a miracle. God had done something wonderful. He'd brought two of every animal to the ark. And they were on their very best behavior. Even the lions lay down with the lambs.
Tigers? Wildebeests? Zebras? Whoa! God will protect us all. Well, that does it. Everybody's here.
What do we do now, Father?
We wait for the rain.
It doesn't look like we'll have to wait long, Father. Look!
Suddenly, the clouds began to gather and cold winds began to blow.
Noah, the time has come to take your family and the animals onto the ark. Soon the rain will start.
Let's go! Everybody on?
All clear down here. Ready. I'll close the door.
Don't be afraid, my dear. God will protect us all.
The rain covered the whole earth. Even the highest mountains disappeared underwater. Except for the animals and people on the ark, there was nothing else left. During their long trip, Noah and his family became very close with the animals. They were all good friends.
Groundhogs hide, and monkeys climb, and long-eared rabbits run. This bunch, I have a hunch, we'll have fantastic fun.
Hyenas laugh at the tall giraffes, skinny legs and neck. Wild toads amuse the kangaroos with leapfrog up on deck.
Noah and his
Noah watched to see when the rain would stop, but it just kept coming down. It rained and rained like it would never stop. It rained for a month, then another week. Then, after 40 days and 40 nights, the rain stopped. Noah was so excited, he called a family meeting.
I've called you all here because I have a surprise for you. The rain has stopped.
What? That's wonderful.
To be true. When do we get off?
Well, I think if all goes well, the ground should start to peek through in about another, 6 months or so.
Everybody was disappointed to hear this news because although they all loved one another, they were all pretty tired of being on that ark. But they waited patiently. Many months passed.
Thank you.
Well, what did you see? What did you see?
Same as always. Nothing but sea.
We're never going to get off this boat. How are we even going to know if the land is dry?
How are we even going to know if we're anywhere near land?
This is hopeless.
Now, what kind of talk is that? Are you the same men who helped me build God's Ark? Hasn't he looked out for us this long?
Of course. Father is right. But can we at least try to find out if there's any dry land?
This got Noah thinking. Finally, he got an idea. He went and got one of the ravens and brought him to the slit in the ark. Then he let him go. He thought if the raven found land, he might bring something back with him. But when the raven returned, he didn't bring anything with him. So Noah decided he would try letting a dove go.
Good luck!
But the dove returned with nothing as well. But Noah knew God wouldn't abandon them. He waited a while longer, then, one last time, he sent out the dove again. This time, when the dove returned, it brought something back. In its mouth, it carried a branch from an olive tree.
Father, this is wonderful news. We must be very close to dry land.
Yes, son. If you believe in God, he will save us all.
And you protected us, too.
And sure enough, very soon, the ark landed on top of a tall mountain. When it was safe to come out, God spoke to Noah again.
Noah, you and your family and the animals can come out now. The earth is dry. Go out into the world and have many children, and tell them about me. And so you will always know that I won't ever flood the world again. I'm going to leave a gift in the sky after it rains. Something to remind you of my promise.
And so Noah and his family thanked God for all he had done for them. And Noah's sons had many, many good and strong children who loved God very much.
how the world began, how God created it by hand, from mighty mountains to the raging sea, to every leaf on every single tree. It's in the holy book, just open up and take a look.
Long ago and far away in the city of Jerusalem, a very special visitor came to town. His name was Jesus. He arrived on a beautiful Sunday in spring.
What's happening? Where's everyone going?
Haven't you heard? It's him! He's here! He's finally here!
Oh! Who's here?
The king! Come on!
The king?
Come on, let's go!
There he is! There's Jesus!
Where? Not that fellow on the donkey colt.
The king on a donkey? He should be riding a golden chariot pulled by mighty horses.
Are you sure he's a king? He looks so ordinary, like one of us.
He may not look special, but did you hear what he's done? He's done the most amazing things to help people. Even when Jesus is very busy, he takes time to bless children.
There was a beggar who had been blind all his life. Jesus touched him, and you know what happened? The blind man could see.
And that's not all. I heard Jesus went to a wedding, and there wasn't enough wine. So he took barrels of water and turned them into wine.
Water into wine? That's nothing. I heard he knows how to walk on water.
Oh, he's such a wonderful man. Nice man.
Make way! Make way!
Come on, donkey. There's a good donkey. Come on.
Good thinking, Andrew. Which way do you want to go, Jesus?
Let's go to the temple. I'm excited to get back to my Father's house of prayer.
To the temple! Come on! This way!
It's been a busy morning. The temple will be quiet and peaceful.
No, it's okay. It's okay. The people don't care. You can bring the donkey in the temple with you.
Bob! You said this was a place of worship.
Well, the more money you spend, the better the blessing.
This should be a house of prayer to honor God, not to make money. But look, it's like an animal farm in here.
This bird is 12 drachmas.
12 drachmas. That's much too high.
Leave here, all of you.
Now. Come, let's go.
Not everyone was happy to see Jesus. Some priests in the temple were very jealous that everyone liked Jesus more than they liked them. They didn't believe that he was the king.
You're always telling us about this wonderful place called heaven. But how do we get into heaven?
Trust in God and trust in me. Love God with all your heart. And love your neighbor as yourself. Forgive people when they do wrong. If people are hungry, feed them. And if they are thirsty, give them something to drink. If someone needs help...
Will you people please stop pushing? We all want to hear what Jesus has to say.
It's all right, Peter. Someone touched me. Who was it?
There are so many people here. How could I know?
Who was it? Who touched me?
I did. I have been sick for many years. I wanted to touch you and be healed.
Now you are better and can go in peace.
Oh, thank you.
From watching what I do and listening to what I say, you can learn how to enter into heaven. Love everyone, rich or poor. Most of all, I want you to learn to love your enemies.
Judas, one of Jesus' disciples, was confused. He had followed Jesus for a long time, but he still didn't understand how to love everyone. He was also confused because he liked having money, and he always wanted more.
I know I dropped it here somewhere. Excuse me, I've lost some money. Have you seen my coin?
Does it have your name on it?
One day, Judas decided to do something bad.
Do you want to know where you can find Jesus?
Yes. Who are you?
I'm one of his disciples, Judas. I can show you where he stays for a price.
Yes, take us to him. He's causing us too much trouble. The people like him more than us now. We must stop him.
What will you give me if I tell you where he is?
How's this? 30 pieces of silver. Don't worry. No one will know what you've done.
All right. It's a deal. I'll come back soon and lead you to Jesus.
That night, Jesus invited his closest followers, the disciples, to a special dinner.
Hello, welcome, Peter and Andrew, and you too, James, John, Philip and Bartholomew. Hello, Thomas, Matthew, and James. Nice to see you, Thaddeus, Simon, and Judas.
What a long, hot day. I'm tired.
Oh, me too. And my feet are filthy from those dirty streets. I could sure use a bath.
I know. Let's get a servant to wash our feet for us.
Good idea. Jesus, do you know of a servant who can take care of us?
Certainly.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm washing your feet. Lift, please.
But I didn't want you to do that. I wanted a servant to do it. You're too important, too powerful to kneel before me and wash my feet.
Please, Peter. It's okay. I want to do this.
And me too?
And you, John. May I?
And so Jesus himself, their Lord and teacher, went around the table with a large bowl of water. He washed everyone's feet until they were all clean.
Even though I'm your Lord, I'm also your servant.
I want to take care of you. And I want you to take care of others, too. Now listen to me. I have something very important to tell you tonight. Someone here is going to do something bad to me. Someone is going to betray my trust and love.
Who? Who is it?
Could it be me?
Or me?
Go ahead, Judas. Do what you were going to do. First, I will give thanks. We thank you, God our Father, because you give us bread to eat and wine to drink. Whenever you eat this bread and drink this wine, I want you to remember me.
The disciples didn't understand yet what Jesus was saying or why Judas had run off. They were confused, but they continued to listen.
This is the last supper I'm going to have with you. I have to go away soon, but don't worry. We'll see each other again, I promise. And I want you to remember, always love one another as I love you.
But we don't want you to go away.
We want you to stay with us, always.
Do you really have to go?
Yes, but remember what I tell you. I'll be back. Soon we'll be together again.
Is someone trying to hurt you? If so, we'll help you, won't we?
My dear friends, tonight you will be afraid, but everything will be all right. But now I want to go outside and pray. Do any of you want to join me?
I do.
Me too.
You can count on me, Jesus.
Me too.
I'll go with you.
I'll be right by your side.
I'll go too.
All right, then follow me.
And so Jesus led 11 of his disciples outside. It was a beautiful starry night. They walked and walked until they got to a hill called the Mount of Olives. It was late, and the disciples were getting tired.
I want to be alone for a few minutes. You'll wait here for me and keep watch, won't you?
Of course we will. We'll be right here if you need us.
That's right. You can count on us.
I'm tired.
Me too.
I know. Let's rest against these rocks and this tree.
Dear Father, I know you love me and are watching over me, but sometimes I'm still afraid of what's going to happen. Please help me be strong to do what you want me to do. Thank you. Amen.
But back in the city of Jerusalem...
Which way is he?
Follow me.
Peter? John? Where is everyone? Sound asleep.
Oh, it's you.
Where am I? What's going on? It's okay. It's time to wake up. Huh?
What's going on?
Hello, Jesus.
Oh!
Come on! We have to protect him.
It's okay. I must go. Put down your sword. This is what God wants me to do.
Oh.
Following the orders of Pontius Pilate, the soldiers who carried Jesus away treated him as though he had broken the law. This was because there were some people who did not believe he was the Son of God. And so it was that Jesus died on a cross with a thief on each side of him. The disciples were very, very sad. They missed their Lord. But soon, a great surprise would happen. Some of the disciples took Jesus' body and cared for it. They brought him to a cave to be buried, as was the custom in those days. Then they put a big rock in front of the cave entrance so no one else could get in. And finally, guards were ordered to stay in front of the cave. 2 full days and nights passed. And then on the 3rd morning,
you hear something? Yeah, what is that? Hey, what's going on around here? Huh? How is that stone moving all by itself? Look!
Just then, some of Jesus' friends were on their way to visit the cave.
We have everything we need, right? Perfume? Spices?
I think so. Now we just need to talk to the guards. I hope they don't try to stop us.
Out of my way!
I wonder why they're running.
Do not be surprised. Jesus is not here. He has risen from the dead. He's alive again. Go and tell all of his friends the good news.
Jesus lives. We must go tell everyone. What good news.
Peter, John, angels, it's unbelievable. He's alive. Jesus is alive again. An angel appeared before me and told me the good news.
I can't believe it. What a miracle.
Incredible. Risen from the dead. Praise God.
I must see for myself.
Have you heard the news?
Thomas, it's so good to see you. I have some great news. Jesus is risen. He is alive again.
Mm-hmm. I know that you've been sad lately, Mary. Why don't you get some rest?
No, really. Everything I say is true.
Thanks for the news, Mary. That's really great. Why don't you go on home now?
Believe me, it's true. Oh, Thomas, I'll see you later.
I'd have to see Jesus with my own two eyes to believe it. Wouldn't it be great, though, to walk into this house and see my teacher's familiar face again? I can almost picture it now. Jesus would be standing here, smiling at me. Jesus? Jesus! Is that you?
Now that Jesus is gone, we might as well fish. Are you ready with the net?
Uh-huh. Come on, John.
Okay. And a one, a two, a three! All right. Let's pull her back in. Pull! Pull! Pull!
Oh, no. Not again.
We haven't caught so much as a minnow.
Let's try it again, I guess. A one, a two, up.
Look! Who's that over there?
Throw your net on the other side of your boat.
What is that going to prove?
Besides, we've already tried that.
Try again!
Why should there be fish on one side of the boat and not the other?
Well, I guess there's no harm in trying. Come on. And a one, a two, a three!
Whoa!
Whoa! Pull! Pull! Look at all these fish! Just look at them!
But how can that be? How did he know that? Who is that man?
Some kind of miracle.
A miracle? Jesus?
It is! I can't believe it! It's him!
Jesus!
Quick, everybody, pull in the nets. Pull in the nets and let's get rowing.
You're back! I can't believe you're back!
Yes, Peter, but only for a little while. You see, I have to go back to my Father in heaven soon.
Are you leaving us again?
You just got back. We want you to stay.
Don't be sad. You should all be happy. Rejoice.
Happy? How can we be happy when you're going to leave us again?
Because I died to make up for all the wrong things people have ever done.
You mean you died for us?
But why?
Because I love you all.
What do you want us to do?
God wants you to be with him in everything you do. And the way to do that is to love everyone, the way I love you. I'm going to make a place in heaven for you. Tell everyone you meet about me and about what I have taught you. And always remember, I will be with you forever.
We'll never forget you. We will tell everyone about your love.
And the disciples never did forget. They went through villages and cities in many parts of the world, telling people about Jesus and the great things he had done.
Thank you.